and I've come here to just to update you on the state of the economy. That the world economy has come down. We had thought that the economy will grow by 3% over this financial year. It is going to contract by 3%. We had thought that our economy will grow by 4%. It will actually contract by 13% in this financial year. We had thought we'll have 62.4 billion pula worth of revenue. We will not have that amount. We'll now have 48 billion. In terms of expenditure, and that expenditure was projected at 67 billion, we will not be able to have that level of spending. In fact, we'll actually go down to 59.6 billion pula. The deficit of 5.2 billion that we thought we would have during the budget speech, we would actually have a larger deficit of 10 billion. The net effect is that the economy has actually taken a beating from the corona. But I want to emphasize that it is not the economy that has caused the corona, it is the corona that has affected the economy. And therefore, I want to encourage everybody to actually heed medical advice around what to do. And therefore, our efforts are going to be concentrated in trying to limit the spread of the coronavirus. Because only after dealing with the corona would we be able to deal and promote the growth of our economy. I also would like to make the point that we have had to revise the budget to look at the various budget items because the revenue that we had expected is no longer there. And therefore, we had to reprioritize our budget and do away with conferences, meetings, and sadly also to deal with the salary increments. That there are many Botswana out there who have not before depended on government for anything, but they are now asking government to provide food hampers. And therefore, the situation that we are faced with is to make sure that each and every Botswana has access to the resources that are in this country and that nobody dies of hunger nor of poverty. And therefore, this budget represents what I think is a near reflection of what we are willing to spend on. And therefore, we are going to continue to reprioritize all the expenditure that we have put in here so that we make sure that Botswana benefit first, and therefore we'll be able to protect the many Botswana that have come through. If I now move to summarize in terms of the COVID fund, we've got 2 billion and 60 million that is sitting in the fund. And we've been able to, and this has been a contribution by the private sector and all Botswana that are there. The 2 billion comes from government. In terms of the wage subsidy, for the month of April, we have received 12,440 applications for wage subsidy. And we have been able to approve 12,413, which amounts to 233,663,828 pula. And there is about 165,681 employees who have been assisted or who are going to be paid in the month of April. In terms of food hampers, we have been able to spend 114,839,250, which has been approved for the Minister of Local Government and Land, Rural Development, to now provide the food hampers for the month of April. We have also been able to spend about 26 million in recruitment of temporary social workers as well as coordinators in order to increase capacity within the Ministry of Local Government to be able to roll out the food hampers that are there. We are currently seized with 2 billion pula requests, 2.4 billion pula requests from the Minister of Health in order to be able to get the necessary medical items to support the fight against the corona. We are working around the clock with the Minister of Health together with Foreign Affairs and the Chinese embassy here to seek to receive these commodities or products from China to be able to help. We continue to receive donations and we want to encourage all companies and all people out there to come to the rescue of this country to help us to mobilize the resources to be able to provide for Botswana and for the people of this country. Lastly, I want to make the point that the coronavirus has taught us a lot of lessons. That this budget is very near to what we think is a true reflection of our requirements in terms of the recurrent expenditure. we are now going to be going forward to mobilize resources for the development expenditure, because we will no longer have the luxury of attending conferences in New York, in Washington, in London, all those destinations, that we are going to have to be the destination of conferences as a country. But as you have noticed, I have not spoken to a post-COVID recovery program. We are finalizing, we are working on that program in order to ascertain how we are going to finance the development projects that we had set out in terms of this financial year. You'll recall also that I submitted to Parliament a midterm review of NDP 11, which midterm review remains relevant and will need funding. And therefore, the corona has set us back in terms of the resources that we need in order to reprioritize within NDP 11 and deliver the projects that we have set out to do. I thank you very much.